delicious? Exclamation. Make a statement without saying a word. Punctuate the air with wit and style. Exclamation. A now kind of fragrance from Coty. Gaetano Menswear, the most handsome of them all. Gaetano, the spirit of family.
Gift is yours with any $35 Fendi fragrance purchase at Hudson's.
Boy, you know, Linda Kenzie is one great boss. I mean, I really thought he was going to blast me, but Harvey said two words to me the whole time. I was the one who did all the talking. I just explained the accident to him, reminded him of my good driving record, told him why Pittsburgh was going to win the Super Bowl, and how I'd like to see that situation in the Middle East cleared up, and he just sat there the whole time with his mouth open. So how's everybody here? Am I talking too loud? No, I don't think I am. Hey, listen, you know, Pittsburgh is going to win. That defense is just too strong. Look at that backfield. Harris, Blyer. Blyer's the most underrated back in the NFL. I mean, nobody blocks Blyer. Blyer, he runs, he blocks. He's got a pair of great hands. Talking about hands, what about Swan? I mean, you can't stop him. Boy, Bradshaw's off. Swan gets the ball. And look at that defensive line. I mean, you realize that they've only allowed an average of 3 yards per carry? And what about those linebackers? Cole, Lambert, Cam. You can't get through them. You can drive a truck through them. I mean, you can't get there.
Boy, am I going to be sick tomorrow.
Come on and join us in an hour of Jet Set fun with Pee-wee's Playhouse tomorrow morning at 9:30 and the California Raisins at 10. Up next, sit back for a night with the King of the Ring. Yo, it's Sylvester Stallone on the Arsenio Hall Show on TV2.
Right, Mr. Walters?
This Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, there's no escaping the Christmas spirit. Because now through Saturday is Highland's Moonlight Madness Sale. With savings of 5 to 40%, it'll turn everyone into Santa. Right now, this Samsung remote control VHS video recorder with high-speed surge is just $199. But it's all over at 9:30 p.m. Saturday. Highland's Moonlight Madness Sale. Now through Saturday.
Introducing the Espresso Mini from Krups. Just the right size to give you delicious espresso. One cup at a time, two cups at a time, or even four cups at a time. Then turn on the steam and watch deep, dark espresso become heavenly cappuccino. As tempting as this. Krups Espresso Mini. It's as simple as black or white.
Available at Hudson's.
Something special is lighting up your child's imagination during the holidays. It's Littlefoot and his friends in the Land Before Time, now on video cassette. There's fun, excitement, friendship, and love. It's an adventure they'll never forget. Get your copy today and look for the offer that's good for a free pizza from Pizza Hut.
Stage 29, downtown on Studio Ozone, Melrose Avenue, in the heart of Hollywood, California. In these United States, on the island of America, it's the Arsenio Hall Show, starring Arsenio Hall. Tonight, Arsenio welcomes see if y'all know this group. What? I got it for you tonight. Yes. This is my posse right here. Give it up for them. Yes. Thank you for the flowers. And those people over there. 12 lords a-leaping, 7 swans a-swimming, 3 French hens, 14 pinheads, and a partridge in a pear tree. That's who they are. Yeah. I'd like you all to join me in congratulating my drummer, Chuck Morris, for getting a star on Hollywood's Walk of Fame. How about it, Chuck? Yes. Oh, boy. That makes me feel so good. I feel like I discovered you and everything, man. That's beautiful. It happened so quick.
You did it again, man.
What?
That's Chuck Norris. I'm Chuck Morris. That's not me, man. You keep doing that.
Oh, the karate guy.
Right. What's up with that?
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. My fault. I'm sorry. We'll just take that out. That won't be in tonight. We'll take that right out. Oh, guys. So I'm driving here this morning from Cleveland. And and I had some thoughts, things that went through my mind. You know, these aren't jokes. These are things that kind of make you say, your thoughts. You know, Jaguar just announced they have a new car that sells for $587,000. Can you believe that? What could a car have for five? I mean, is Janet Jackson in the trunk of this car? Their new slogan would be, this is definitely not your father's Oldsmobile. You ever drive, and I saw this morning coming in from Cleveland, you ever drive and see that that bumper sticker that says honk if you love Jesus, that kind of stuff? I was behind a guy and I started honking. And I honked for like 2 miles. And he got out and wanted to kick my ass. I was honking, you know? Yeah. I don't know what to do. I was like, he got out, what's wrong with you, man, blowing at me? I love Jesus, man. He said, oh, I'm sorry. God bless you. Ever been thirsty late at night? Have you ever noticed, like, I have a bathroom up on the second floor. How come we go to the kitchen? Why won't we drink out the bathroom? It's strange. I didn't want to get a glass. I just need a little bit of water. But I went all the way downstairs in the cold, you know, to get the good water. What is the deal? It's all the same plumbing. Think about it. We take that trip for no reason. It's all the same plumbing. I think we don't like to drink water near where we pass water. I think that's the problem. It's a weird thing. But we brush our teeth with that same water up there. You know, it's like, it's all right to use it, but don't swallow it. It's not the good water. Ever apply for a job and they ask you if you're currently using hard drugs or if you have a record, felonies, anything like that? You know, if you're an honest person, you're gonna just say no. If you're not an honest person, nobody's just gonna, you know, I mean, tell them, yeah, well, you know, I'm on cocaine and you got me. What can I say? It's so stupid. It's so stupid. And you know, because you know if you tell them the truth and you're a bad person, they're not gonna give you the job. It's not like you're gonna say, well, what can I say? I gotta be honest with you. And then the guy says, well, okay. It does say here that you have a nasty heroin habit and you've stolen from most jobs you've worked. Looks like you murdered somebody in 62 and you're a Satan worshiper. But because you are honest, Mr. Ramirez, welcome to our company. You know? What is that about? Oh, man, a friend of mine just put a phone in and they gave her a little card that says, in case of phone repair, it's a hotline. But if your phone break, how can you use this damn number? You know, give me a tin can and some string or something. You know, it's like, you know. Christmas time is here, and I see a lot of Christmas stories on television, and I saw a special on Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, which warms my heart. And while I'm watching this, yeah, Rudolph. But have you ever thought about this story? They dogged Rudolph off. You know what I mean? This is not a happy story. Rudolph got dogged. I mean, he was a little different than the other reindeers, and they used to dog him. He was banished from the North Pole, right? they wouldn't let him play in any reindeer games, you know that. Just because he had a red nose, you know. Then finally, I guess they were nice to him, but they had been dogging him. When they started being nice to him and asked him to come hang out on that suicide mission they did, I think I would have had an attitude if I was Rudolph. You know, oh, you need my nose now, huh? Forget it, fat man. Just forget it. Forget it. Yeah. You've been dogging me out because of my nose? Yesterday I was big tomato nose. Now you want to use it. Get Blitzen with his brown nose to help you out tonight, okay? I saw an old episode of Lucy last night. What was the deal with Ricky coming home every single day? Lucy, I'm home! You know, let me ask you a question. How many announce every day when they walk in the house? How stupid is this? You walk in the house like, I'm home. First of all, they only had 3 rooms. Right? When you come home, everybody know you there. It's not the Clampett Mansion, okay, Ricky? It's so stupid. Lucy should have told him one day, look, Ricky, sit down. Ain't but 2 adults here, okay? I don't even work. If somebody comes to the door, I know it's you. Man, some of you are probably still in school. I remember when I was in high school, they always had a concept called the teacher's lounge. What do the teachers do in that lounge? Yeah. Probably all the things they tell us not to do. Right? They're probably in that lounge with spitballs and, you know, rubber bands and stuff, doing the wild thing on the table, you know. I bet that's what the teachers do. Oh, gosh, we got a fun show for you. I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry, what? That's your teacher? Thank you for screaming that out, sir. Excuse me for doing a show. Yeah, I mean, he had some kind of flashback or something. I don't know, and scream, Miss Popilski! I'm sorry. I was smoking some Dutch cleanser before I came here. And I flipped out, I'm sorry. I won't say that no more. Go back to sleep, man. We got a great show for you tonight. I need some funk to tell him about this. Yeah, I need some funk.
But not the regular funk.
Yeah. Oh, I don't have to tell this crowd where to clap, because they got the groove. Yeah. Yes. I heard it. Bass man, can I get some? Yeah. One of the greatest actors of our time. He don't even do talk shows, but he came for you. Robert De Niro. Yeah. Go, Michael. Go, Michael. Go, Michael. Go, Michael. Go, Michael. Bring it down. Ooh. From L.A. Law. He's a hunk, ladies. He's a hunk, ladies. He's a hunk, ladies. Harry Hamlin. Oh, I like that. I like that. The men and women all paused. Yeah, the men and women all paused. Hey, Michael, can you give me that pause before I say this next name? Okay, you all know him. Some of the jamminest brothers ever out of Beantown. You ready?
Yeah.
Pause. New Kids on the Block. Get busy.
Touchstone Pictures. He was the powerful governor of Louisiana. She was the queen of Bourbon Street.
Miss Bliss, stop!
And when they met...
You made love to a governor before.
Not that I know of.
Sparks flew. What they did shocked the nation, but what they found was a special kind of love. Paul Newman.
Still love me if I wasn't a fine governor of the great state of Louisiana.
Lolita Davidovich.
You still love me if I was flat-chested and worked in a fish house.
Blaze, rated R. Now playing at a theater near you. Check newspapers for showtimes.
If they could see us now out on the deep blue sea, underneath the moon and stars, just you and me. Come aboard and see why Carnival's the most popular cruise line in the world.
But when I look at that sign, I think of the great ones.
5, 4, 3, 2, you say what?
I like living in Hollywood.
To live life to the fullest.
You're a star in your own mind.
I am full of rage to have fun.
You're not yourself.
To have a good feeling about yourself, you can have good feelings about other people. One.
The best relief from this hectic season is a jingle away. Ring in the holiday in 30 minutes or less. Domino's Pizza. Nobody delivers better.
For every man who wears Brut, there's a woman who loves what he smells like. Because there's something about Brut that's nice to be close to.
Honey, I was just thinking about you.
Brut, it smells like a man.
My first guest is a two-time Academy Award winner who stars with Sean Penn in a new film called We're No Angels. It opens everywhere today, and these two guys play two inmates who are on the run and undercover as priests. Here's a preview.
Can't help if you don't tell me.
I've been sleeping with this woman.
Huh? All right, and what? You're not married to her?
No.
You married someone else?
My wife.
Your wife know about this?
No.
Well, what are you worried about, though? Forget about it. Why?
But I broke my vow. I'm such a sinner. Help me.
Okay, look. Try to break off, see this broad, say 10 Hail Marys, make a good act of contrition. If you see the girl again, pop back here, no big deal. God bless you.
Please welcome Robert De Niro.
Yeah, if you want to.
Gosh, I went to see it last night. Uh-huh. Little screening on the lot. How much fun was that doing? I mean, you and Sean.
Well, we had a lot of fun doing it. I was going a little broader than I usually do, but I figured, you know, I'd just see how it worked that way, and we had fun doing it, you know.
Yeah. So. Now, was that your decision or the director's decision? Because I noticed, I mean, I watch your work, and you were out, as far as being broad, you were out there.
Yeah, I was. As we went along, I decided to go, as I got into the way that I was doing it, I picked it up a little more and a little more. So it was, I got more into that kind of groove of how to do it. And sometimes I wasn't sure whether I was going too far or whatever, but, you know, it was just like a choice I made, and if it worked, it worked. If it didn't, it didn't, but at least I made the choice.
Yeah. You were also the executive producer, and executive producers sometimes have to talk to or discipline actors. Did you have to talk to yourself every now and then and say, hey, you're late, man?
No, executive producer is really sort of a, it's not a real, it's a title that can be interpreted in many different ways. So I had there was no conflict there as far as dealing with myself.
Yeah.
I had gotten everybody together, and Sean and I wanted to do a movie together, and we got Art Linson, who was the real producer of the film, to come up. He came up with the idea of David Mamet writing a screenplay, mm-hmm. so that's how it got started. So that I felt, though, that at this time I might as well take the credit of executive producer.
Yeah. But you had Art there with you. He's a talented man who's not only worked with you, but worked with Sean before.
Oh, yeah. He's worked with Sean. He did Fast Times at Ridgemont High, and I forget, maybe there was another movie. I don't know. Sean's in the wings. Maybe he can tell me.
Is Sean over there?
No.
What was it like preparing for the role, and how did you prepare?
Well, this was a different type of film that I didn't prepare the way that I would normally, say, you know, every character, every script is different. And this one, I I just didn't prepare the way I would in terms of a lot of research and all that. It was just, I kind of kept it on the surface in a way.
Mm-hmm.
We're two ex-cons, we escape, and so on, and...
You didn't go to prison or hang out with priests? Or...
No, I've done that before for other things, but For this, it didn't seem necessary because the guys were not priests, first of all. So the whole comedy is about things that they don't know. So mm-hmm. So if I learned anything, it would make it, it would just make it maybe harder. That was my approach.
Yeah.
And it was more important just to have fun with it, not to get too heavy.
Yeah.
You know?
When you prepared for Raging Bull, you gained how many pounds?
60.
60 pounds. Man, I have a hard time with my weight. My comedy weight is about 260, 270.
Uh-huh.
And I try to keep it there, you know. What would make you want to gain 60 and have to then lose it?
Well, it was hard. You know, the first 15 pounds, I mean, I've answered this question about 6 million times,
mm-hmm.
but the first 15 pounds of fun, then after that it becomes work, because I have to eat very early in the morning to a breakfast to digest the food in order to eat a big lunch in order to eat a big dinner, and it became like in 30, 40 pounds, it became like a drudgery, very difficult. I couldn't see my feet when I was tying my shoes, and I was always out of breath, and my feet hurt in ways that I had never experienced before because of the extra weight, and I was happy to get it off.
Yeah, and it was very rewarding in a sense because, like, I've been reading magazines like American Film and Premiere, and here at the end of this decade, they've decided that Raging Bull, in many magazines, is one of the favorites, best films of the decade. I mean, you must be real proud about that.
I am. I'm happy, and I'm very happy for Marty Scorsese.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm surprised, too, you know.
Yeah, that's good. You want to take one right now? Let's take a quick commercial and come back with Robert De Niro.
Every year, one of my favorite holiday rituals is writing out my Christmas cards. It gives me a chance to share the joy of the season with my family and friends all across the country. Again this year, I'm taking time to attach a special symbol of caring. A Christmas seal is my way of helping a cause I believe in and spreading the Christmas spirit. Make this a season for giving.
Emotion. Xerius de Givenchy.
your holiday gift with any $20 purchase from the Zarius Collection, exclusively at Hudson's.
For years, man has gone to the extremes to find the perfect gift for the special people in his life. We've even performed feats superhuman. Spent endless hours searching and searching and searching. But today, at Federal Collateral, we've made it simple to surprise that special someone in your life. At Federal Collateral on Washington Boulevard at Michigan Avenue, we go to the extremes for you, not only in quality, but in price.
Smart Santas are desperately trying to get into Wonderland Music early this year for Crazy Clarence's riot sale. Smart Santas know that Wonderland Music has the largest inventory with everything in stock, much selling below cost. Now through this Sunday, Swinger Line Extra Deep Professional 5-piece drum sets from only $398. Yamaha keyboards with full-size keys from only $189. Yes, the rush is on to Wonderland Music for Crazy Clarence's Christmas riot sale, where everything in the store is up to 50% off. Shop Wonderland Music's 3 locations now through Sunday, and you'll be a Smart Santa too.
Next!
From MGM UA Home Video.
Dr. Zhivago? I love Dr. Zhivago. The romance, the adventure. It won 5 Oscars.
Get this screen epic for only $29.95.
I love Dr. Zhivago. Next.
From MGM UA Home Video.
Ben-Hur, the fury, the spectacle, the chariot race.
Ben-Hur, a screen epic for only $29.95.
I love Ben-Hur.
I'll just tell them about it, because, you know, a lot of girls were mad at me, man. I would walk, like, down the street or in the comedy store, and people would just look at me like this. And I knew why they were mad, because De Niro wasn't here. And that was, like, last week. You want to tell them what happened?
Well,
He was supposed to be here last Friday night, and...
I was doing a scene with Robin Williams, and he... Just a freak accident. His elbow hit my nose and broke it, and we could actually hear the... hear it on the soundtrack. And
ouch.
But my nose was broken before when I was a kid, so actually he straightened it out.
Yeah. Lucky break.
Yes. It was a freak accident anyway.
Yeah. Last night we had probably one of the funniest men in the world and my new hero, a little guy named Danny DeVito here. You gotta do a movie with this man. He's so funny. Have you met Danny?
Yeah, I know Danny. Yeah.
You know Danny?
Yeah.
He turned this place out last night.
Yeah,
man.
I heard.
You should get together with him and do something.
Well, we're talking about something. I don't know. We're developing it now, in fact. It's about two brothers in Chicago. It sort of spins around Chicago politics and so on, but it's still not ready, so we're just still developing it. But hopefully it would be something.
That's good, then. That's good. I read that Steven Spielberg said, I want to work with De Niro so bad it hurts. When are you going to stop hurting the man? Work with him.
Well, we talked about something to do. I don't know what will happen with it because the script wasn't ready either, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah. There was another thing I wanted to ask you, and I got to get this out. The movie Big with Tom Hanks?
Yeah.
You turned that down?
I didn't turn it down. It didn't work out. Penny and I worked on it for a while together, and then it just didn't work out with the studio and this and that. There was a lot of nonsense went down. So I just, I just finally just couldn't happen. Mm-hmm. I was sorry it didn't happen because I like the story a lot and I wanted to do it and I like Penny a lot, but it just didn't happen. So
you'll maybe work with Penny on another project.
I'm working with her now on Awakenings with Robin Williams.
Oh, okay. So she's directing this.
Yeah, yeah.
That's good. She got your nose broken. In a sense.
Yeah.
In a sense. Let's talk about Oscars. What does that feel like? You have one for Godfather, supporting.
Mm-hmm.
And you got another one for something. Raging, probably.
Raging Bull, yeah.
Yeah. What does that feel like?
Well, it's a nice feeling to get it. It's hard to sit there and put yourself in a situation with other people where you have to, like, be competitive in that kind of way. So it's that is difficult. And You always hear people complain about that, so I have mixed feelings about it. But it's nice to get the recognition at the same time. It doesn't mean anything, and yet it does mean something. So it was always that sort of conflict and, like I said, mixed feeling about it. And you don't feel, if you're going to set that kind of thing up, then you've set it up, and it's some, a lot of times people feel that the people who really deserve it don't get it, and I feel that too. So what are you going to do? I mean, what? And yet it's been established. It's like the most important, say, award for
an actor.
Actors or directors or whatever. And yet it's been, it does mean something, you know. Mm-hmm. So I had those mixed feelings about it.
Yeah.
It, you know, it's, so what can I
do? Now you're doing, you're involved kind of at the forefront of this situation in New York called Tribeca.
Mm-hmm.
So one day some future actors will have Oscars thanks to this resource. Tell me about Tribeca.
Well, I lived down there, and I wanted to, I always had the thought, I guess I've been hearing other people say this to me, that if they ever, like, had the chance to open a restaurant or whatever, I always wanted to have a place, if I had the chance, if I was ever in a position to do it, and I'm lucky enough to be in a position to have like a center, like a film, in my case it's a film center, a place where people can get all kinds of energy coming together and sort of things happening. It's like sort of casting a movie or a play, getting all these different types of people together in one place, one sort of community, film community, because there's not really anything like that. I mean, there's the studios, but there's no real like center or place for people to interact. A couple of right. things, but they don't quite work. I mean, I don't see them working. And
yeah.
so that I wanted to, this thing started. I saw a building that I liked, and then I someone who I was working with managed to get it in place with the people who own it and so on. And we wound up creating this. I said if I could, I would try and create this center. So that's, and I, found a person, a woman named Jane Rosenthal, to sort of run it and oversee it, and it's coming along very nicely. But it's, and who knows how it'll wind up? It'll be a, it'll take on a life of its own, yeah. and we'll see. But yeah. it's very exciting, anyway.
Yeah, I talked to.
I don't know if I'm answering the question. Really,
absolutely,
you know.
Absolutely, and I think it's good of you to kind of put back to the youngsters that, you know, of tomorrow. Involved in this. I may be reaching for straws here. John Astin said something to the effect of, when he did Midnight Run with you, things got a little too realistic sometimes. And I didn't know what he meant when he said that.
Well, I heard the story you were talking about. I guess it was in the train thing. We have that sort of that fight in the compartment. I guess that's what it is. Because we had, you know, our encounters were always like hitting each other and, you know, this sort of competitive whatever, you know, we were doing, and I guess I hit him or something, and I got very upset about it, yeah. according to, because I forgot.
Yeah. You forgot but that you hit him?
I forgot the incident.
Yeah.
Unless somebody can remind me, but.
Yeah.
I know how you, I was upset, and you get very upset because in movies, something can happen so easily, nobody plans an accident, so I'm very, very, very careful. I've been in sort of hairy situations where something could have happened. I was lucky it didn't, but in Raging Bull, people say, well, you know, you just got your nose broken, but in Raging Bull, nothing happened. Nothing really did happen, but we were so careful and so wary of anything that might happen, we didn't. We were real, real careful, but Robin felt the same way when he, you know, when he hit my nose by accident. You just feel awful. You know?
Yeah.
I hurt somebody. Because it's only, you know, it's only make-believe, it's only a movie, it's only an illusion, you know, and you just, you gotta be careful, whatever.
Have you ever been in a situation in a movie where you actually thought there was a life-threatening situation about to happen?
Well, once, when I did The Deer Hunter, I was, there's a helicopter sequence. We went, John Savage, myself, Chris Walken, we were coming down the river on a log, and had to hang up. It was all done with a lot of cameras hanging on the bridge, and then the helicopter would actually come down, and we'd get in a helicopter, and it would take us away. Mm-hmm. And the last take, we were up on the bridge, and the helicopter came down, and there were two cables here. It was like a man-made bridge across a narrow pass of a river, and there were cliffs on either side. And the helicopter couldn't go too low because of the currents of the river and so on. It was very narrow. So we were going and waiting. The helicopter was down, and we're trying to get ready to climb up into it. And there are these sort of, I don't know what you call them.
Those prongs.
They're down. They kind of land the helicopter, like the sled thing, whatever,
yeah.
Comes up. And we're on this side of this thing with a cable. All of a sudden, the helicopter thought we were on it. The guy, the pilot, thought we were on it. It got under and lifted the whole bridge. So when we were here, this was a railing. We found ourselves hanging above just flipped the whole thing over. So I thought it was going to come on top of us.
Yeah.
So we went down. Dropped in the water, and was a strong current, so when we came up, we were like where the orchestra was.
Yeah.
And there were boats waiting for us, but one of the pilots came out and pulled it. It could have just come down on everybody, because it happens a lot, you know, it just happens.
Well, I'm glad everything worked out all right, and I'm glad you're here with us tonight, man. Good luck with this movie. Good luck to you and Sean.
Thanks.
And come back and see me again.
Okay.
It's nice of you to stop by. Robert De Niro, New Kid. Next.
Sometimes I dream I'm in Italy, driving this incredible sports car. And my boss is there. He says,
"We need a ride to the shareholders meeting."
Now, here's where it gets weird. The sports car has four doors. I mean, there's no such thing as a four-door sports car. It's just a dream, right?
When Kathy started rehearsing, she went through a lot of changes. She changed her moves, her look, her timings. But in 34 days, she never had to change the batteries in her cassette player.
You can depend on me.
Now Kodak batteries have been improved, so you can depend on us to last longer.
And here's the best thing to happen to your camera since Kodak film. Kodak PhotoLife batteries.
Coming on video cassette. It's been called astonishing by Newsweek.
Always do the right thing.
I got it. I'm gone.
And the New York Times calls it fabulous. Spike Lee's Do the Right Thing. Coming to video cassette January 11th from MCA Home Video.
He thinks she should do the vacuuming. She thinks he should do the vacuuming. But Hoover thinks the vacuum should do the vacuuming. Presenting self-propelled cleaning. The Hoover Concept One Cleaner. Hoover invented it.
Okay, quiet down.
We know what millions of girls all over the world want Santa to bring them for Christmas. My next guest, performing the hit single, Funky, Funky Christmas, from their platinum album, Merry, Merry Christmas. Please welcome the New Kids on the Block.
Celebrate with a rhyme. Tandy D, are you ready? Ready as they'll ever be.
Steady! You know, Joey Jones.
Joey and I, yo. All right. We're going to get funky tonight. Huh. Come on, y'all.
Everybody sing.
Have a funky, funky Christmas. Have a funky, funky Christmas.
A party here, 'cause on the phone, that's the posse at the door, should have stopped.
No!
Cool.
in the air. Kick the ballistic Santa Claus.
Funky, funky Christmas.
On Christmas Eve, I saw a sight you wouldn't believe. St. Nick by the fireplace, dusting off his booty with the runner's face. He said, Harrison, buddy, save you a switch. I left the fire burning and he burnt as much. So now I've learned, you gotta turn to my best outside of what they burn.
No feel in the air, the party of the year. It's going, it's showing, fresh round the room. It's going outside, but we ho, ho, ho. Santa's on the way, sleigh bringing, bring it, swing it.
Everybody shout,
have a funky, funky Christmas.
Here. Wherever I look, there they are.
Don't pay twice the price for famous brand toys. Toy Liquidators, an 82-store chain, buys surplus inventories and closeouts from name brand manufacturers immediately after Christmas, when prices are lowest. Now, you can buy today at after Christmas sale prices. Stretch your Christmas dollars on first quality toys, where you'll recognize the bargains. 9 locations, Livonia, Taylor, Belleville, Rochester Hills, Southgate, Berkeley, Sterling Heights, Birch Run, and Monroe. Don't pay twice the price. Buy at after Christmas prices today. Hurry, supplies limited.
It's holiday time in our hometown. A special time, so much to do.
Here are three more great bi-weekly specials from Schneider's. Old-fashioned boneless half ham, just $3.49 a pound. Or Schneider's skillet strip bacon for just $1.79 a pound. And Schneider's natural casing bologna in our New York deli is just $2.99 a pound. Great bi-weekly specials and low prices every day, only at Great Scott.
From the Great Scott family.
Hey!
Rock 94.7 WCSX.
Compare Chevy Cavalier to Ford Escort. Cavalier has more passenger room, more engine, and more power, yet it's priceless. Can't see the comparison? Neither could I.
For value, nobody's winning like today's Chevrolet.
It's big, and it's going on right now, and your Chevy dealer's got it. The last great deals of the decade on Chevy's best-selling cars. Deals that make you a winner. But they're going fast, so see your Chevy dealer now for the last great deals of the decade.
Yale and has played all kinds of classic serious roles, but as an attorney on L.A. Law, he romanced Susan Day in a very, very unusual outfit. Sandy?
Actually, I'd like to have a few words with Miss Van Owen. It is still Van Owen, isn't it?
This will only be a moment. What? I'm in the middle of getting married.
Just tell me that that's the guy that you want to spend the rest of your life with. I know this is a hell of a time to say this, but I'm in love with you.
I'm sorry, Kevin. Well, let's go before I change my mind.
Things we do for a laugh, you know. I mean, I went to college. I mean, you said I went to, you know.
Yeah.
I have a degree. It was very serious, but my alter ego, I carry him with wherever I go because he always gets the girl.
Now, where did this idea come from? Did Steven come up with this? Steven Bochco? Who came up with this?
Well, it sort of evolved. The first conversation that I ever had with Bochco, we were talking about how serious this show could become. And I thought, you know, who's going to want to watch a serious show about a bunch of lawyers? But I had remembered doing research on another project a couple of years before, and I'd been down at the civil courthouse.
Mm-hmm.
And I was waiting for some papers to be delivered so that this case could go on. And in walked Frankenstein right into the court, right up to the judge, and delivered a batch of papers. And nobody paid any attention to Frankenstein whatsoever. You know, he was just there in his big clodhopper boots and all that. And I waited another few minutes, and in came this guy who was dressed like a werewolf, you know, and it was Halloween Day. And
yeah.
Apparently on Halloween Day at the courthouse in L.A., it's a tradition to come dressed up however you want.
And yeah.
I said to Stephen, well, what happens if you're in the middle of a murder case waiting to be sentenced and little Bo Peep walks in with the papers? You know?
Yes.
But anyway, he took the idea, and I ended up wooing Susan with that. And then we did the wild thing later at home.
With that on. Yeah. Do you think you and Susan will ever get back together?
We can get back together. I don't know what they have in store for us, but the wild thing, yeah, we'll be doing that.
Boy, oh boy. How is Dimitri? Am I saying it right?
Dimitri, my son.
Yes.
Dimitri. Oh, he's amazing. He's coming here. We're going to go skiing. He'll be here next week.
Where does he live?
He lives in Rome. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when I first realized that he was going to be living 6,000 miles away, I thought that would be really a problem.
Yeah.
As far as being a good dad and us having a great relationship. But I speak to him once a week for an hour at a time. Mm-hmm. We're one-on-one, we're on the phone. And I don't remember ever having that relationship with my father. And as a result of this, and sometimes it's 2 hours.
Yeah.
As a result of this, we are just like that.
Yeah.
I mean, very, very tight. He's 9. I'm 30-something.
Yeah. No, that's very important, man, because I, like yourself, didn't have that kind of relationship with my dad, man. It's so important to talk, you know?
Yeah. Well, when you're living at home and your dad goes to work and, you know, basically what you're supposed to be doing is taking the trash out on Saturday or doing the chores around the house, that becomes kind of the focal point of the relationship.
Yeah.
And dad's tired, he comes home from work. And I didn't spend a lot of time with my father, you know, that, you know, quality time. We never talked for an hour at a time. And so it's very special, I think, to have that with him.
Show you're right. We'll be right back with Harry Hamlin.
Well, we got this commercial thing? Santa Fe cologne for men. Discover the mystery of its attraction.
Legend has it, Santa Fe is located above one of the Earth's magnetic forces. Perhaps that's why for centuries men have been drawn to it. Or maybe it's a life unrestricted by convention, or the color of the air, or the call of the coyotes. Or maybe it's something that simply can't be explained. Santa Fe cologne for men. Discover the mystery of its attraction.
He's not getting balder, he's getting better. Beyond Bond, he's this year's sexiest man alive. Sean Connery in this week's People. And for the first time, People let you in on 10 sexiest runners-up. This week, Man Alive. People, that's what we're all about.
Put the power of an upright in the palm of your hand with the Royal Dirt Devil. It has a revolving brush, and it can handle all kinds of dirt. Pick up the handheld vac that really picks up. Dirt Devil by Royal.
In response to popular demand, we proudly introduced the Nikon Teletouch 300, a totally automatic dual lens camera that significantly reduces red eye.
Mama always said, when the going gets tough, the tough go shopping. If the shoe fits, buy it. But never shop till you drop. Drop into Burger King for new pick-em-ups.
Delicious all-white meat chicken tenders and crispy new fish tenders with your pick of tasty sauces.
Mama also said, never talk to strangers.
Excuse me.
But hey.
Even after sleeping 4 long years, the Duracell batteries you know and love still give you the life you need. There's a date that proves it. Duracell, with 4 years storage.
Who is it?
Who is it?
I'm always mistaken for Giorgio. I'm just as fabulous, but smarter. I'm Primo.
Primo.
Why pay so much more for Giorgio when Primo costs just $8 and lasts as long as you do?
If she likes Giorgio, she'll love Primo.
Dinner at 8. If I'm not mistaken, it's a remake of an old movie, right?
1933, MGM made the original. It was from the Kaufman play. And it's been updated to 1989. And I play the part that John Barrymore played in the original. Mm-hmm. It's a coked out, drunk addict type who courts failure and in the end dies. So it's not really uplifting, everybody, but you might learn something by seeing it. And it was a great part for me to play, very different from this dour lawyer that I play on L.A. Law. So.
Yeah, I guess basically it's on one of Turner's...
TNT, Turner Network,
yeah.
And I don't... It's on a few more times. I don't know when exactly,
yeah.
But...
They'll check their local listing. Yeah, they don't mind. Those are some hellified socks you wear, man. I can't help but to notice them.
Yeah, well, Santa decided to come to town on my feet tonight. You know, this outfit was kind of black, but and these socks, just in case you're interested, they do on their own kind of they signify Christmas, and they have a lot of good cheer, but they also play music. I don't know if you can hear this.
Wait, oh, boom it, Bart, or whoever's up there.
Can you hear this? it's.
Oh, wait.
Try it again.
Yeah, that's cute. Do you mind if I talk about one of my favorite Harry Hamlin projects? Only two movies have ever made me cry, and you were in one of them. And this is a weird movie, but at the end of Making Love, I cried. You remember that movie? I know you remember.
I do.
Plus,
remember.
I love the Roberta Flack track that she did.
Oh, it's amazing.
That the words, yeah, man, tear you apart, man.
Extraordinary song. Well, that was that movie, which we made in 81, I guess, still for me is very special and one of the most important projects that I think I've done. Mm-hmm. The theme, of course, was a little odd for the time and mm-hmm. remains a little odd because I played a gay man who managed to bring a straight guy sort of over into the fold. And, it's kind of, when I think back on it, I have a great deal of respect for having done it, but on the other hand, it's funny when you play a gay man the way you're perceived mm-hmm. by the industry. You know, you can be an axe murderer and you can kill a lot of people and dance around to strange music while you're doing it, and it seems to be okay.
Right.
And nobody thinks that that's who you really are, but you play a gay man, and suddenly, well, of course, no offense to gay people, but right. I was misperceived after I did that for a while.
Yeah, because you have Dimitri and you're not a gay man. You played it so well. Let's take a commercial. We'll be right back.
I was in Phoenix. I had to give a speech. While I was working on my speech in the hotel room, I started coughing. So I called down and the front desk sent up some cough syrup.
Not all cough medicines work the same.
This stuff was for kids. It wasn't for me. Then I sat down for something stronger, and they sent up Vicks 44.
Today's Formula 44, as effective as doctor-recommended codeine without narcotic side effects.
That Vicks Formula 44 kicked that cough.
Formula 44, as effective as codeine but non-narcotic.
I don't want to cough again, but if I do, I'm taking it.
It's not just a shoe. It's top gold. Power. Strength. Balance. Top gold. Athletic footwear that's unsurpassed. Now introducing Spats, a new concept in athletic footwear.
We're wrapping up Christmas at Shoppers World. Everything's marked down, prices will astound, and it's all in stock, so just watch the clock. Midnight Madness is here for your holiday cheer. The prices are right until 12 midnight.
Save up to 40% during our Midnight Madness sale with fashions for the family and more. Shop our 8 locations till midnight, Friday and Saturday. Look for our ad in the Detroit News.
It's convenient for you with big savings, too. We're wrapping up Christmas at Shoppers World.
Aretha Franklin is back in her first appearance downtown in years at the Masonic Temple Auditorium. Two shows only, Friday and Saturday, December 22nd and 23rd. FM 98 WJLB welcomes Aretha Franklin, plus special guest, Peebo Bryson. Tickets now at the Masonic Box Office on Ticketmaster or charge by phone. She's the Queen of Soul. She's Aretha Franklin, coming live to the Masonic, a Fresh Ring production.
I spoke to him with my eyes.